The curtain rises once more then on the desert stage of Sakhir as the players take their places for the opening act. Will they enthrall us like they did in 2014 with that titanic battle between Nico Rosberg and Lewis Hamilton? Well, we'll find out shortly as we get underway here in Bahrain. We go racing today around 3.36 miles of the magnificent Bahrain International Circuit, with 15 corners and two good passing opportunities into turns 1 and 4. Keep an eye out for drivers locking the front left tyre into the tricky braking zone of turn 10. And it's an absolute pleasure to be joined once again by Anthony Davidson. Let's begin by talking about Antonio Giovinazzi. As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed they'll be starting out of position today due to a power unit component change. So it's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. It's McLaren in pole position there. And starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Verstappen, Alexander Albon, and Leclerc, Hamilton, Perez, Grosjean, and Lando Norris, Ricciardo, Magnussen, Kimi Raikkonen, and Stroll, Hülkenberg, Gasly, Robert Kubica, and George Russell, Kvyat. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
We'll be right back.
the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Green flag. One lap of extra fuel. Fuel target, plus one. Okay, some information on Raikkonen. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring the car. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Okay, the safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Is coming in for a stop. Approaching the safety car. You're leading, so don't pass it. Stay behind the safety car. Has boxed for the mediums. Car behind on the medium tyre. forget, box this lap. Some information on Russell. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Safety car is in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember, there is no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. Is 1.8 seconds. enabled. Some information on Leclerc, they're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. We advise moving to Mix 2. Fuel to Mix 2. Whatever the problem was, they're coming back up to speed. We're leading our teammate by 1.8 seconds. damage, but only a few laps left. If you can live... of fuel remaining. Catching the car ahead, but be aware that these tyres need to last till the end of the race. This lap of the race. Keep this up. Excellent drive.
Here's Here's our winner pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
Without a doubt, the safety car changed everything today. The key to their success was keeping calm and reacting to the situation quickly. We've seen teams in the past throw away wins because they were too hesitant, but here they were decisive and that's allowed them to take the advantage.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. So, let's review the driver's standings. Sebastian Vettel now leads the Drivers' Championship. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
My driver of the day has to be, no question, Antonio Giovinazzi. Such an assured drive from one of the sport's newer stars, and a performance he can be very, very proud of.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the construction.